everyone! In this video, you'll learn the basics for using the NVDA screen reader for Windows, so you can start screen reader testing your web pages. For more information on manual accessibility testing, check out the resources below. To start, make sure you're using NVDA in Chrome, because that's the most common and compatible browser for NVDA. We also recommend following along with this video, so you can start practicing the keyboard shortcuts. Before you can start using NVDA, you'll need to download it at nvaccess.org/download. Scroll down and select Download. Once it is downloaded, select the .exe file. You might start hearing NVDA announce what's happening at this point. Select I agree and install NVDA on this computer.
NVDA. I agree. I agree checkbox not checked Alt plus A. Install NVDA on this computer. Install NVDA.
I unselected Use NVDA during sign-in and kept Create Desktop icon and shortcut key selected. Now I can select Continue.
Use not checked. Continue. Installing NVDA dialog. Please wait while NVDA is being installed.
It's successfully installed, so I'll press OK.
Success dialog. OK.
I'm just going to use my mouse to finish these settings. I'm going to keep the keyboard layout desktop. If you're using a laptop, you'll want to change that to laptop. And I'm going to select Use Caps Lock as an NVDA modifier key and press OK.
Open. Expanded. Desktop. Laptop. Desk. Welcome to NVDA dialog. Welcome. Checked. Welcome to OK.
I'm going to turn NVDA off by selecting my notification overflow area, right-clicking on NVDA, select Exit, and select OK.
Notification overflow, NVDA, NVDA, exit, NVDA, OK.
Or you can use the keyboard shortcut, which is your NVDA modifier key plus Q. So that would be Insert or Caps Lock plus Q. Now, we're ready to start from the beginning by turning NVDA on. We'll turn it on by searching and selecting it in the application search bar. Or you can use this keyboard shortcut, Control plus Alt plus N.
Welcome to
NVDA starts announcing the Welcome to NVDA dialog box. I'm just going to select OK. Next, I'm going to change some of my NVDA settings to make it easier to understand and use. You'll only have to do this once. With NVDA running, I'll select my NVDA modifier key, which is either Insert or Caps Lock, plus the N key.
Main NVDA menu.
I'll use my arrow keys to navigate to Preferences, then Settings, and select Enter to select it.
Preferences Settings. NVDA Settings.
First, I'll change my speech settings. I'll down arrow to Speech and then Tab to the Change button and select Enter to select it.
Speech 2 of 13. Speech Prop Change.
I'll use my arrows to change the synthesizer to Microsoft Speech API version 5, and then tab 2 and select OK.
Select synthesizer. Windows 1 Core Voice, no speech. Windows, Microsoft Speech API version 5, audio, OK button.
I'm then going to tab to the voice option and use my arrow key to change it to Microsoft Zira.
NVDA settings, voice.
Microsoft David Desktop English.
Microsoft Zira Desktop English.
Next, I'll change my vision settings. I'm going to Shift plus Tab to the categories list and down arrow to vision. In vision, I'm going to tab to the Enable Highlighting checkbox and select Spacebar to check it.
Synth Edit Categories List Braille Vision 4 of 13 Vision Property Page Configure Space. Checked.
Lastly, I'll change my keyboard settings. I'm going to go back to the categories list and go to keyboard and tab to the speak typed words checkbox and select it with the spacebar.
Categories, list, keyboard 5 of 13. Keyboard property page. Select NV, speak typed characters checkbox checked Alt plus C. Speak typed words, space. Checked.
Now I'm going to tab to the apply button and select enter. And then tab to OK and select Enter again.
allow, beep, speak, place, handle, OK, but cancel, apply button, Alt plus, categories, keep, beep, place, hand, OK button.
The last thing I'll do before we start navigating a website is turn on the speech viewer. If you're not used to using a screen reader, the speech viewer will show everything that's being announced as text, which can be helpful. I'm going to use my mouse to open the notification overflow, right-click on the NVDA icon, select Tools, then select Speech Viewer.
Help, Tools, View, Speech Viewer, NVDA Speech Viewer.
I have NVDA set up, so let's learn how to navigate a web page using NVDA. I have Chrome open on the PopTech homepage. I can use my typical keyboard navigation keys, which include Tab and Shift plus Tab, to navigate by interactive elements like links and form fields. I can also use Spacebar, Enter, and the arrow keys to interact with these elements.
List with 5 items feature, courses link, blog visit, schedule a demo, login link, main landmark, schedule a demo.
I can navigate by headings using H and Shift plus H.
Main landmark, PopTech, powered by Wave Graphic, heading level 1, the power of Wave, at the scale you need, heading level 2, accessibility information fast, heading level 2.
Another way to navigate the page is to use the up and down arrow keys to go from line to line.
Web accessibility evaluation tool. Now, PopTech lets you categorize, along with your, an assessment of its graphic PopTech dashboard, heading level 2 accessibility in PopTech.
One other useful navigation tool is the Elements List. The Elements List shows a list of links, headings, form fields, buttons, and landmarks. You'll open it using your NVDA modifier plus F7. In the Elements List, I can select links or jump straight to a heading or region on the page.
Elements List dialog. Tree view. Type. Grouping. Things radio button checked, Alt plus H. Tree view. Quickly deploy resources where they're needed most. Quickly deploy resources where they're needed most. Heading level 2.
To read content, select your NVDA modifier plus the down arrow. So I'll press caps lock plus down arrow. It'll start reading where your visual focus is. To stop reading, select control.
Heading level 2, quickly deploy resources where they're needed most. Which department is the best at accessibility? Which needs more training?
The last thing we'll go over is browse and focus mode. Browse mode is what we've been doing. NVDA will automatically change to focus mode when we tab into a form element. Focus mode just means we won't be able to use keyboard shortcuts to navigate until we tab out of the form. For example, using H to navigate headings. Instead, it'll actually type a letter H, which makes sense because we are in a form field where we might need to type the letter H. We'll hear a sound indicating we're in focus mode.
Name star edit blend.
When we tap out of focus mode, we'll hear a lower pitch sound.
Did we know? Submit message button.
For more reading and navigation keyboard shortcuts, check out the resources below. As you screen reader test, you'll get more comfortable using NVDA to navigate. To help, here are all the keyboard shortcuts we went over in this video. You're ready to start using NVDA with Chrome on your own website.